Hello guys, Jingjing here. So many of you probably know me from my travel vlogs in Xinjiang, in Mongolia and Tibet. And I really love sharing my trips and the amazing stories, amazing people I met on the road. But this vlog is not about my trips. Many of my followers know that my job is a journalist. So in this vlog, I'm thinking about to share with you some behind the scenes stories of my job. For example, right now I'm in front of Tiananmen. In about 6 hours, a grand ceremony will be held here to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the founding of Communist Party of China. So for those of you who haven't been to Beijing or who haven't been to Tiananmen, let me give you a little tour. So the street I'm standing in right now is Chang'anjie, Chang'an Street. And on this side is Tiananmen. On this side is Tiananmen Square. And I also want to show you these two fantastic buildings. Over there, do you see that giant building? That's Grand Hall of the People. Every year in March, the two sessions will be held there. And on this side is the National Museum of China. And over here, you can see some yellow chairs. These are the chairs for the audiences for tomorrow. So this is the area for audiences. In the morning, the audiences will come here, watch the ceremony, and also have a seat. Over there, that's my seat. This is my seat. I already put my stuff here. I have so many stuff. So, because we have a lot of work to do, that's why we have to come here early. Later, I will try to take 1 hour nap, 1 or 2 hours, and then get ready in the morning, because in the morning, the choirs and also a lot of other people will come here for this ceremony. So, see you in a bit. See the cameraman? These cameramen are setting up the camera and the cables here. Those are the janitors. Not an easy job. Rise and shine, everybody! Daylight! It's 5 o'clock in the morning, 3 hours to go. And now I'm gonna change my clothes because I want to dress formal. And more people are coming to this venue now. For example, walking behind me are the choirs later. They're gonna sing. So, see you soon. Guys, I want to show you this new sculpture here. Do you see that? This red bridge shape sculpture in the square. This represents the history of Communist Party of China from 1921 to 2021. And underneath it, there's a red carpet. And later, all the soldiers will carry the China's national flag and walk all the way to
there. Do you see that pole in front of the Tiananmen? Later, they will raise the flag over there.
2 hours to go, and audiences are gradually getting to this stage. And you can hear the music, right? That's the military band rehearsing now. And the soldiers also rehearsing over there, practicing the steps, because later they're gonna walk all the way to raise the national flag. And you already saw the choirs, right? Let's take a look at the military band. Yeah, over there. Thank you. start very soon. Audiences from all backgrounds are already here waiting for the ceremony to start. This is really truly a historical moment, a very proud moment for a lot of Chinese people. Some of them are members of CPC, some are not. They are teachers, soldiers, students, workers. They come from all kinds of backgrounds and also all kinds of ethnic backgrounds. So I want to share some stories about the people that I talked to earlier before the ceremony. Because a lot of people, especially in the West, I think they don't know who are CPC, who make up CPC. And those people, I think, are the perfect example to explain who really make up CPC. For example, this couple, they are from e-ethnic group. They have been teaching kids from impoverished families in Daliangshan, the most impoverished region with the most hostile environment in Sichuan. But they devoted themselves teaching all those kids in the remote mountain for over 31 years. And also there's a kid, I probably shouldn't call her a kid because she's at her 20s. She's much younger than me. She's studying in the college. She's a member of the choir. And she's so proud of being a member of the CPC. She comes from a family that her parents, her grandparents are all CPC members. And her parents actually went to the village to help the villagers. So now she's became one member of the CPC. She's so proud of it. And she wants to be just like her parents to help more people.
我有个问题啊，就是因为你很年轻嘛，才20多岁，然后可能很多人会很好奇，就是说20多岁年轻人怎么会这么的爱国爱党，会怎么这么坚定这个信念？很感激我现在的生活，我之前也看过，就是有一些人的评论呀或者啥的，但是我感觉就是人一定要学会珍惜当下，就是我如果出生在一个别的国家或者出生在一个别的地方，我不一定能够就是实现我现在所能实现的很多。 东西，所以我就是从心底的感谢，就是我出生在这个地方。就是我现在特别珍惜我现在的生活，我觉得很开心，每一天就是生活在这种和平的年代，然后在这样一个就是相互尊重、就是平等的这样的一个社会里头，就是让我觉得非常非常心不快乐，生活在这样一个环境里，让我感觉我们身边每一个人都有自主选择的权利，对，都有，
看觉得了很大的希望，对吧？未来充满希望。
对，我觉得就是让我能够一直快乐到老的这样的一个，一个这样的一个条件。
从你的身上能感觉到，你非常的这个有这种阳光啊，这样开心的力量。来，我们一块儿来，打个招呼。 And also all the members of the audiences come from different ethnic backgrounds. For example, this crowd I went to talk to, they are from all kinds of ethnic backgrounds. They are Manchurians, Tibetans, Mongolians, and also all kinds of ethnic groups you probably never heard of. And all of them have one goal, to serve the people. That's the people who make up the CPC.
你好，你叫什么名字？
我叫平措斯人。我就是在学校做一些相关民族团结的一些宣传呀，一些对孩子的教育啊，
育
对对对。
优秀，你也是党员吗？
我也是党员，对。
您是入党多少年了呀？
我入党，我是2011年入的党。
2011年入党，
对，10年。
那你觉得党员身份对你来说意味着什么呢？
意味着就是要做的更多，然后有更多的义务、更多的责任，去做好自己的这些本职工作，然后起个先进带头这样的一个作用。
谢谢谢谢，奖牌勋章好多啊！请问您叫什么名字？
尹建敏。
啊？
尹建敏。
尹建敏。
啊啊。
哦，您的这个服装是满族的服装，
对。
哇，那您的这一个我看有脱贫攻坚的、民族团结、先进个人的、三八红旗手，各种各样的公司都有。那您是非常非常优秀的模范。您的党龄有多久了呢？
我是无党派人士。
啊？
我是无党派。
无党派人士。
啊，
但是也可以获得这么多荣誉。
对啊，对
吧？
啊。
我是甘肃的，甘肃苏南玉谷子自治县。我叫贺敬贤。
贺敬贤，
哎，
您这个是哪个民族的服饰呢？
我是玉谷族的。
玉谷族。
玉谷族，我们是交手民族。在祁连山下，我们守护着祁连山。
哇，这个民族可能很多人都相对不是那么熟悉，比较少听见，对不对？
哎，对对对。
这个民族大概人数有现在有多少？
现在有1万多一点。
1万多一点。
哎。
然后您的这个勋章，我看全国民族团结进步模范个人，您主要是做了哪些工作获得这个奖呢？
我主要是抓好这个脱贫攻坚跟乡村振兴在这一块。
厉害厉害，谢谢。我可以在这里跟他合个影吗？
大家看，我们各个民族的优秀代表、优秀模范都在这里，大家好，打个招呼。我看您有一个这个的奖章。可以看哇，全国抗击疫情、新冠肺炎疫情先进个人，对这个奖章的故事是什么呢？
我是在2020年2月7日，带领我们吉林大学第二医院132名医疗队员奔赴武汉，我们奋战在武汉华中科技大学同济综华新城院区，那里是新冠肺炎疫情重症患者最多，也是云集高水平医疗队最多的这样的院区，我们在那里奋战了60天，我们也创造了很多的全国纪录，包括我们一例70岁埃克毛撤机的这样的一个全国年龄最高的一个救治记录，我们也圆满完成了党和人民交给我们的医疗救治任务。
好，祖国加油！
祖国加油！
您好，我看到您身上有这个勋章，这个勋章是怎么回事啊？
勋章是全国五一劳动奖章，完成了立足岗位，搞了很多革新创造，然后2014年获得了国家科技部2等奖，
哇，
然后组织上国家授予了我这个全国劳模的荣誉。党员是工人阶级的先锋队嘛，是承担着建设祖国的一个重任。他的宗旨就是全心全意为人民服务，所以作为一名共产党员，我感觉到非常的光荣和荣耀。
谢谢，走来，快跟您合个影啊！